Hello. I apologize in advance for the noises. We're actually outside today, so I've got neighbors doing stuff, and there's a ice cream truck running around, which is kind of creepy in and of itself. But the reason I am dressed like this, and I had this whole little stocking thing going on, was I wanted to talk about Woad. I first kind of got interested in Woad because, if any of you have heard of the Highlander TV series, there was a scene where there was an ancient Celtic immortal and she was putting on, actually eyeliner on her arm in video. And I was like, why didn't they use the real ingredient? Because, you know, pretty much anyone will tell you woad is made from a plant, which, yes, actually woad is a plant, yes, it's made from a plant, but the painted warriors probably didn't actually wear the plant. Visions of nude blue warriors adhere themselves to the psyche, especially with movies like Braveheart and King Arthur. You know, I've kind of did the Braveheart thing today with half my face blue. I think probably this would be more like something that they would do, but really we don't know what designs Celtic, quote-unquote Celtic warriors would have done. Woad really is a plant. That's not some sort of mythological thing. And its correct scientific name is Isatis tinctoria. Sorry, it's probably said completely wrong. Latin is definitely not my forte. I've heard that this plant's been mixed with cow urine, distilled cow urine, to make the woad paint for the warriors. I've heard that it was mixed with fat, and then another person told me that I needed to read the Abenagi. Actually, that would be said Mabinogion, or at least that's how I would say it, and how most people I know say it. Supposedly in the Mabinogion, there's a list of 7 different ingredients that go into woad. I've never seen this in the Mabinogion. I've, you know, granted, maybe I have a different copy than someone else. However, most likely, I don't think that's true. Woad itself produces a dark black color like indigo. It doesn't actually turn a pretty blue until it's exposed to air. So if you're mixing it with fat or distilled cow urine, it's just going to look like black crap smeared on, which you could achieve the same thing with coal from a fire. So we know that woad is blue because our good friend Julius Caesar said that the blue that these warriors wore was like Bertram or something like lapis, so it's a really bright blue color, it's not black. So we know that it is blue for sure based on the observations of a contemporary, Julius Caesar. Yes, I know, he's a dick. The other issue with the woad plant being used to make woad is that the woad plant didn't actually show up until the latter part of the Iron Age. So, nude blue warriors running through the mist probably didn't happen for centuries upon centuries because the woad plant wasn't actually in Britain at that point. Now, I've talked to some people that have tried to recreate this crazy woad mixture with the, you know, fat or distilled cow urine or whatever they use. And they said that the problem was is that it would smear or it would just flake off, much like what I'm wearing here. If I touch it, it smears. I mean, it's smeared all over my frickin' face before I started. I had to, like, wash my ear off because it got on my hair. And then I put my hair behind my ear, and my ear was all blue. So that will be another problem with mixing with fat or cow urine. So we have black crap that would just smear around or flake off. So that's not very good either. Also, the Mayan reenactor associates have stated that this woad concoction did not smell good because apparently the woad plant when you've mixed it up to make dye with it, smells terrible. So you would have black, greasy, stinky guys running around. So I just, you know, the more I hear about this, the more I kind of don't believe that it is this plant being made into paint. Now, if you think about it, perhaps unknowingly, the individuals who, or the writers that came up with the Highland series, might actually have been onto something if they're using eyeliner. Because what are primary components of eyeliner? Metal oxides. And we knew that the Celts mined metals. You know, they actually were pretty good at mining. So, you know, maybe there's something to it. They would definitely have access to metal oxides. Of course, we don't have a living, breathing immortal. As much as I'd, you know, like to talk to, you know, Duncan MacLeod of the Clan MacLeod, or Mythos, they're really not around. They're not immortal, so we don't have an actual immortal to talk to. But we do have somebody that we can observe and can kind of bear a silent witness to what actually was going on.
In 1984, in Lindow Marsh, in Cheshire, United Kingdom, two peat cutters discovered a well-formed human foot, which led to the discovery of a mummified body of Lindow Man a few days later. Lindow Man was dated to be about 2 BC to 119 AD, sometime in the middle of the Celtic Iron Age.
So the peat cutters found this fully formed foot, and the reason the peat cutters are cutting peat is because in Ireland, or places where they have bogs, like Denmark, Ireland, and wherever else, they dry the peat out and they use it to burn instead of wood. So once they found this foot, they called the cops. The police came out and they kind of excavated the area. I guess I can't say kind of. They did excavate the area and they pulled up a mummified body. The gentleman that they dug up, they named Lindow Man. There now are perhaps 400. Well, my friends just recently, because we were just talking about this, said there were 400 different bog bodies discovered now. So I think that's really amazing. And I'm actually going to talk about another one that's near and dear to my heart, Clonny Kevin Man. But right now we're talking about Lindow Man. What's very interesting about this body and why he's a mute witness to what was going on with pigmentations was because they tested his skin and they found ferrocyanide oxide and clay-based paints, but no plant-based paints. So that kind of maybe blew the whole Woad being a plant thing right out of the water. And to support that, I'm going to read you a quote.
All the tests for indigotten, the colorant in Woad, were negative, and the test itself is very sensitive. And this is according to Lindow Man, Body in the Bog, page 41.
So there are only some hints from contemporary writers and this kind of incomplete scientific evidence as to what Woad was and if it was actually made from a plant and that sort of thing. However, you know what, I think it's safe to say that they probably did use metal oxides. Now, they probably didn't only just use blue, they probably used other colors, but unfortunately Caesar and the contemporaries focus on the blue, so maybe that was their favorite color, or maybe that was a specific tribal thing. You know, a certain tribe did this, and a lot of that is associated with the Pictish people, which may or may not have been a Celtic tribe, and Pictish means painted people. So to kind of wrap this up, if Woad was such a superior blue, brilliant, wonderful color, why don't they use it today in modern cosmetics? Because I can tell you, when you pick up an eyeliner, it's going to have a whole bunch of stuff, blah blah blah, and then metal oxides of some kind. Even this right here has metal oxides in it. So I think that right there just debunks the whole Woad plant theory. So thanks for watching. Sláinte.